In today's modern era, a camera is no more than a feature on everyone's mobile device. The novelty of owning a camera is currently almost non-existent, considering that everyone has one. Not only does everyone have one, but almost everyone uses one on a daily basis. Today's generation has the ability to take thousands of photos on a whim, without thinking twice. But that wasn't always the case. All we have to do is travel back in time a couple of decades ago to an era where a camera was only for the most experienced individuals. An investment that would cost anywhere from between $500 to $600. Not to mention, you also had to buy film in order to take the photos. But once you got in, the investment paid for itself with the experiences you'd have with it and the photographs you'd take with it. This is why I've started using my Uncle Alan's film camera when taking photos instead of my phone. It forces me to slow down and think about what it is that I want to document before pressing the button. Then, after taking the photo, you won't be able to see it until it goes through the developing process. I have learned to do the developing process by hand in my photography class, which, while faster than sending it to a Walgreens, still takes a full day's work. All that effort goes into creating a final product that turns out more beautiful than any photo taken on a phone. There's a special feeling that transports you back in time, but rather than telling you, let me show you.
You must remember this. A kiss is still a kiss. A sigh is just a sigh. The fundamental things apply as time goes by.
Lately, this camera has brought new purpose into the way I document life. After messing around with it for about a month, I came to wonder, what's the story behind this over 50-year-old camera and what history comes with that? To answer this question, I had to go straight to the source of the camera, my Uncle Alan and Aunt Michelle. So I guess my first question is, how did you end up getting the camera?
I was in Vietnam, during the Vietnam War, and if you were lucky enough to survive it, you get 1 week off, and they would take you out of the base camp, and you could go somewhere to spend a week. I think it was in Hong Kong, I think so. And the military had a store there, and it was called the China Fleet Club. This is all my recollection from 50 years ago, and I'm pretty sure I'm on the money on it. Now, my original thinking was, you know what, I buy a camera, and when I go back to the base, I still have another 4 months, a year, whatever, and I'm going to take some pictures of what I see in Vietnam, the guys that I'm with, places where we went to in Vietnam, and they weren't fun places. The reality was I left it in my briefcase and never opened it till I got back to the States.
After he answered my question about the camera, we continued talking. This now became about more than just a camera. It became an outlet for me to have a deeper understanding about the tragedy, but also glimpses of hope during my great uncle's time in Vietnam. Never had I sat down and talked to my great uncle about his time, as for many, it's a very touchy subject. But this camera became a gateway into me seeing what life was like and how someone could find any hope during one of the most tragic wars in the United States history. My Uncle Alan and Aunt Michelle then showed me the medals that my Uncle Alan earned, including the Purple Heart and Bronze Star. I came to learn more about the camera, but I came out learning more about my great uncle and the courage that he had to have when going through the many challenges thrown upon him. All of this tied to a single question about an old camera that my Uncle Alan bought while in Vietnam. While the story of my Uncle Alan getting the camera might not be that interesting, what that camera lived and went through is something I will never forget. The next time I take a photo with that camera, I'm not only going to think about the image that I'm about to take, I'm going to think about my family and the history that gives this camera meaning with every photo it takes.
So it sat maybe 50 years until you got it. God love you. You know how to use it. No one better in the family than you could use it. I love you. That's the story, doll of the camera.
Thanks
use
so much.
It in the best of health.